My name is Amit Agarwal. I'm a Google Developer Expert for G Suite. In this tutorial, I'll show you how you can send personalized text messages with the help of Google Sheets and your Android mobile phone. You can send text messages to any number in your country as well as global phone numbers if international texting is enabled on your phone. The messages will go directly from your phone, just like you manually send a text message, and you will thus only pay the standard text rates to your cellular service provider. So here's my Google Sheet, and it has a few columns. It has the name, the greeting, the location of my contacts, and their phone number. It has the status field that will show whether they have been sent the SMS or not, and the text column will have the actual text message. Now for this example, our text message would read something like this. Now this is the text message template, and here we have three personalized fields. We have the greeting, the name, and the location. These will be different for every text message, rest everything would be same. There are several ways to construct this personalized text message for each row in the Google Sheet, but to keep things simple, I'll use simple concatenation to generate the text. Now I can drag this crosshair and extend it to other rows, and it will automatically fill the formula for other rows. Now here's my Android, and as you can see, the screen has just two buttons, fetch and send. So when I click the fetch button, what it does is it connects to the Google Sheet and gets a list of all messages that are in my Google Sheet along with the phone numbers. Now this app is fetching data live from the Google Sheet, and I'll quickly show you one more example. So I'll add one more row to the Google Sheet. Now when you are adding phone numbers to the sheet, remember that Google will treat them as normal numbers. So it's always a good idea to prefix that number with a single apostrophe, and automatically that would be treated as text. So I've added the new row, and as soon as I hit fetch, you can see that the new row also shows up in my list. Next, when I hit the send button, a personalized text message would be sent to each row one by one. You can also see that the status column in the Google Sheet has been updated to reflect that the messages have been sent successfully to each of these rows. Now building something like this is super simple. I'll walk you through the whole process, but if you aren't into coding, you can simply copy paste stuff and you should be good to go. So the first step is to convert this Google Sheet into a format that our Android app can read this data. Now this is easy. So go to the Tools menu in Google Sheet and choose Script Editor. And here we'll write some code in App Script. So the first thing we need is the sheet URL. And we also need the name of the sheet that is holding our data. Now let's write a doGet method. Now this is a callback function, and basically whenever somebody calls our web app, this function would be called, and whatever data it returns, that will be returned by the web app. So let's see how this data would look like. So I'll just put them into the log. The first time you run any app script function, you will have to authorize the script, because essentially it is reading data from your Google spreadsheet. We'll use array destructuring to get the header and data in separate variables. Now in this data, we are only interested in three columns: the phone number, the text message, and the SMS status column. We are interested in the status column because we only want to send text messages where the status is blank. So if a recipient has already been sent a text message, we don't want to send them another one. So that is the reason why we are looking at the value of status column as well. Next, we'll iterate through each row of the user input. And obviously, we are only interested in rows where the status is blank. So we'll create an array with the row ID, the phone number, and the text message. We'll convert this array of array to JSON, and then we'll use the content service of app script to return this data in JSON format. Next, I'll go to publish and deploy this web app. You should choose me under execute the app as setting. Next, choose anyone, even anonymous, under who has access to the app setting, because the app should be able to access your Google Sheets data without authorization. Looks good, click the deploy button and you'll be presented with a URL. This is the URL to your web service that will connect the Android app to your Google Sheets. I'll open a new browser tab and open this URL. You can see that it has access to all our spreadsheet data, but in a format that other apps can understand. We need to make one more change in our app script. So when our SMS sending app will send a text message, it will send a post request to our app script with the row number so that we can update the status column of that row in the Google Sheet. So let's write a doPost method for this. And it will have one parameter, that is the row parameter. Here I am not interested in the other user input values, I am only interested in the first row that has the column titles. We are getting the reference to the cell that contains the status for that row, and then we'll update it using the setValue method. We can just return a blank text because our app won't be processing the return value from the post method. So this looks good, but remember that whenever you make any change to the app script, you need to publish a new version of the app. So for that, we'll go to the publish menu again and deploy a new version. So our app script side is done. Let's now build a basic Android app that will read this data from the Google spreadsheet and send the text messages. Now open the App Inventor website. Now you need to know languages like Flutter, Dart, Java, and so many others to build apps with Android. But with App Inventor, you can build fully functional Android apps with simple drag and drop. No coding required. So let me create a new app inside App Inventor. Now you can just follow along. For this app, I'll turn on material design. I'll also give my app a nice title. Next, I'll drop some components into my app. First is the list view, and this will be used to display a list of messages that are read from the Google Sheet. I'll change the background color and change the height also so that it occupies the entire height of the Android app. And I'll also reduce the size so that more text fits into the screen. Next, I'll add two buttons to my user interface. One is for fetching messages from the Google Sheet, and the other one is for sending text messages. We'll also bring some non-visible components into our app. First is the notifier component, and this is the one that is used for displaying progress messages and alerts. Next is the texting component, and this is obviously used for sending text messages. You can actually click on the question mark to read more about any component inside App Inventor. Because our app will be making web requests to our app script service, we will also drop the web component into our app. We'll require two web components. One is for making the GET request, which is for reading data from the spreadsheet. And the other web component would be required for making POST request. So when the app sends an SMS message, we need to update the data into the spreadsheet. And that's why we need the second web component. So the design is almost ready. Let me pull in the Android emulator to show you how the final design would look like. So this is a live emulator, meaning that as soon as you change something inside the App Inventor, the emulator screen is updated automatically. So for instance, if I change the size of this button to say 130 pixels, you can see that this is updated in the emulator as well. Similarly, let me make the font bold. Okay, so the design is ready. Let's now work on the blocks that will do the actual work. So I'll click this blocks button to switch to the block screen. Now if you're seeing this for the first time, it may take a while to get used to this, but believe me, if you make one or two programs, you will love this. We'll initialize a global variable called Google script, and this will point to the Google app script URL that we had created in the previous step. We'll initialize another global variable called Google Sheet Rows, and this will be a list. Now list is just like an array, and this will hold the data that we fetch from the Google Sheet. So first let's write the click handler for the fetch messages button. Now before writing any logic, let's see whether this really works or not. So what I'll do is I'll pull the notifier component, and I'll show a simple message when this button is clicked. Now I'll pull in the Android emulator and check whether this works or not. The fetch button is working, so let's write the actual code that will pull in data from the Google Sheet. So we'll use the webget component for that. First, we need to specify the URL that needs to be invoked when this web component is called. Next, we'll actually invoke the GET request. Now this is an asynchronous operation, meaning you make a GET request, but the server may take some time, maybe few seconds or few milliseconds, to return a response. So when the response is returned, another event is invoked, and that is GOTText. For First, I'll display a simple alert to show whether the connection to the spreadsheet is working or not. Yes, it seems to be working. So now the server returns data in the JSON format and we need to decode this JSON and then save it into a global variable which is Google Sheet rows. After the JSON values are stored in our global variable, we'll update the list view to show these messages. This white text is barely visible in the list view, so I'll update the font color. And I'll make a fetch request again, and there you have the data again. Next, I'll create two procedures here and you'll soon understand why. Procedures are just like you have functions in JavaScript, so you have a function name and then you have parameters. So the first procedure will be used for sending text messages. It will take two parameters, one will be the phone number and another one would be the text message. Next, we'll configure the texting component. Now this requires two things, the phone number and the message, and we have both these values through our parameters in the procedure. So there are two ways to send messages inside App Inventor. You can use the send message API or you can use the send message direct API. I prefer the latter option because it lets you send messages automatically without the user having to confirm whether the message should go out or not. The next procedure that we'll write will update the Google Sheet when the message is sent. Now this will take the row ID as an input parameter. Now here again we'll make a post request to a Google script and it will have a single parameter and that will be the row. So we are getting close. We have to complete the final piece of the puzzle and that is read our list and then send messages to each item in the list one by one. And this process should be initiated when the user clicks the send text messages button. So we'll create a for loop and this loop will iterate through every item that's in our Google spreadsheet. Then we'll initialize a few local variables and you'll soon understand why. So if you look at the JSON data, you can see that each array item has three values: the row index, the phone number, and the text. And their positions are 1, 2, and 3 inside the array. So for each item, we have the phone number, the row ID, and the text message. We'll store them in local variables. We'll add a notifier component to give some sort of a progress indicator to the user when the messages are being sent. I'll pull in the Android emulator again to see whether the functionality so far is working or not. We aren't actually sending the messages, just displaying the notifications, and this looks good to me. Now let's pull in the send text message procedure that we created earlier. And this requires two input parameters, the phone number and the text message. And we'll get these from the local variables that we have just created in the loop. After sending the text message, we also need to call the update Google Sheet procedure because this will update the values in our Google Sheet once the SMS is sent for a row. The messages have been sent, and as you can see, the status column in the Google Sheet has been updated as well. So this is how you can send text messages, personalized text messages in bulk using your Android phone and Google Sheets. Until now we have been running this app on the desktop inside the emulator, but now you need to run it on the phone live, right? So go to the build menu and save this APK file to your computer. You can then use Bluetooth to transfer this file to your phone, install it there and run the app live. I hope you find it useful. Thanks.